We're creating this bomb Princess Leia cake today, you guys. Hello, my name is Ryan Howard, and today I get to show you how to create this extremely elegant Princess Leia doll cake. Let's get started. Now to create this cake, I'm starting with my Wilton's doll cake pan. One of my favorites. I cannot deny how much I love this cake pan. I cut it in half, added buttercream into the middle, and then placed on my second layer. Now you can totally just cut this into three layers of cake. I wanted this to fall like a little bit below her waist, and turning this two layer cake into three layers adds probably about an extra half an inch of buttercream in the middle, and I didn't want that, so that's why I only did two. Now I'm gonna do all of the cake basics and then just crumb coat this baby. Now you're gonna notice that my set looks very old here because I totally forgot about this video. I think I shot this when The Force Awakens came out, and then I forgot about it when Last Jedi came out. So now we're here at The Rise of Skywalker, and finally I get to publish this baby. Which is fitting because this is Princess Leia's last outing. Shout out to Carrie Fisher, I love you. Now after I gave this a crumb coat, I rolled out a very large piece of fondant. This fondant piece is 10 inches in diameter. I picked it up and just draped it over my entire cake. Now instead of smoothing out the sides, I'm just enhancing all of the ruffles on the bottom of the cake to add some fabric folds. So it makes this dress look like it's swirling. Then into the middle goes my Princess Leia doll. You see how it falls right before her waist? Told you, that's what I wanted. Now I'm gonna cover her waist with a little bit of fondant and just blend it into the rest of the cake. Then I am going to add some fondant to create her top. Now this is gonna be kind of like a backless dress. It just makes things so much simpler when you're creating a backless dress. It's also not gonna have sleeves completely attached. Now the thing that I found extremely difficult about this Princess Leia cake was I wanted it to have the feel of the iconic white Princess Leia dress, but I wanted to change it and update it a little. So the original had these like really billowy arm sleeves. How do I translate that and make it modern? So I came up with this really loose sleeve that kind of just hangs off the side of the top of her dress. Then I started to panel. So I'm paneling a piece of fondant. Oh, look at my arm, it's so big. It's shaped like a boat sail, and I'm not paneling it up and down, I'm paneling it at an angle so that it looks like it's flowing in the wind. And I'm using a small fondant tool. What was this? I think this was a piece of jewelry because I didn't have all my fondant tools at the time. So I'm using it to kind of add some fabric folds to make it look more realistic. And I'm just gonna replicate the same folds all the way around the cake. Now the iconic dress had this like white hood, and I wanted to incorporate that as well. So the way I did it was by adding a cape that had a hood in it. So I have a round piece of white fondant. I'm just draping it over her shoulders, and the piece that hangs down the back, I'm just gonna cut it with a pair of scissors to create the hood. Gonna fold it down a little bit. But that was so simple, right? Such an easy way to create a hood. And voila, my Princess Leia cake was complete. I love the way that her arms flow out like this. She's so stunning. My only regret about this cake is that the background is white as well as the dress. It totally gets lost. I love making doll cakes, man. I just can't believe that I designed a dress. That's crazy. And I hope you guys are excited about Star Wars as I am. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I love you. I will see you very soon. Peace!